This video, we are going to understand how to install your PySpark using Anaconda and Jupyter Notebook. So, four simple steps. Let's begin. First step, we'll just go and try to find out the Anaconda. It's a simple website. You go to just Anaconda download and you can search for the free download icon on the menu bar. I'll just accept all and see there is a free download I should be able to find on the top bar. I go there, select. Now here, it's allowing to give you that download and you'll have to add up that dip, but you can skip the registration. Go for download for Mac. So that's what I'm downloading for. Once it gets downloaded, it will take some time. So let's see the download right now. It's happening. Okay, the download has been nearby completion. Okay, once it is completed, just click on it. It's like installation. Even Windows can do the same thing. You'll have to do the installation here and let it get installed now. So I'll select all the terms and agreement and it's downloaded. I want to install it for all the machines. Okay. So once this step is completed, now this is the step where I will have to install my Java. So for that reason, I'll say conda install OpenJDK, which will bring me JDK 11. As I have already installed this earlier, it's not going to take me long time, but when you're doing it for first time, it will ask you for a proceeding yes, no. So you'll have to add up that. Yep. It is just checking my environment. So it says it's already installed, but the command remains same. Once this part is done, next thing is the very important one where we go and say conda install PySpark. Now PySpark is your Python Spark library and it will again be, I have already installed this earlier, so it will just say yes, but for you it will ask, do you want to proceed in something? Now I will say conda install -c and I'll say conda forge, and I'm trying for a library which is called as Findspark, which is responsible for going and finding the Spark installation on my machine. So this is a very important implementation. So see, here it's asking me where do I find it, and I give it the procedural yes, that's it. Now this is all steps which are required for installing PySpark. Now you go on your terminal, type PySpark, and it will straight away give you that Spark shell. Once you get this shell, Spark is installed. So that's it. And next, we'll see how to start with the Jupyter Notebook. Go and find out for your Anaconda Navigator. There, you will find there is a Jupyter Notebook. Just launch that notebook. Once the it will take a minute to launch, it will work on localhost 8888. On the right top, there is an icon for starting a Python notebook. You start that Python notebook. Better name it something. And here, I am going to import my Findspark, because obviously this notebook has to be connected to the Spark. So I'll say Findspark. Then let us see, how do I execute this from here? The command is control and enter. So control or return on Apple. And yeah, let's give that a try. So control enter. Yeah, it executes. And I will create a create cell down. Now from Findspark, I am picking, I'll have to say initialize that first and also then find it. So there will be two different things I will be doing here, Findspark init and Findspark find. Once it finds, it will tell me the location. So now it is telling me where my PySpark and everything is installed. Next, as you have seen, I was able to call Spark session on that console. Now I obviously need connection to that Spark session here. For that, I have to go and do an import. So obviously from PySpark.sql, I will go and import Spark session. So I say import Spark session. So once this import is done, I will go and use this Spark session to now load my, just to give the connectivity to my Spark session. So I'll say Spark is Spark session dot builder. There is a builder available here which will allow me to connect, and if there is any special session available, it will connect to that. Plus I can see my name of the application here. Later on in the videos, when we go to Spark UI, you will be able to understand that. And you say get or create. So if it is there, give it to me. Or if it is not there, we'll create. So it is telling me that, the port is binded and you want to change the port, you can work upon it. Then I want to create a data frame now, which is the basic unit in Spark SQL. So I create a data object first. I say my data is the name and the department in which that employee is working. So I use my name Zartab and department is IT. Then I use my friend's name Arun. His department is admin. So I create that array here first. Then I'll create a list for my columns. So for those columns, I will simply just say the name and the department. So I add up that name and my department. Once I do that, this is where I will say my data frame is equal to spark.createDataFrame. If I pass the data as a source, what it will do for me is it will simply just add up that data with _1 and _2 as my column name, but I don't want to do that. So for that reason, I need to pass the list. So for passing the list, what I do, because I have passed the, I guess it's a set here. So I just want to change that. It should give me an error at this point. Okay. So if you see, it says it is not a list. It should be a list of string and they got just a list. So I will just make use. What I have to do here is, I think I'll have to add up an asterisk symbol just before my columns to get it converted into the list of string. Yeah, I think that because the error, it is saying that it is not a list of string. So if I go and add an asterisk symbol now at before my columns, this error should go away now. So if I press Control Enter, see that list is gone. And now if I just simply go and say data frame.show or tf.show, it should start showing me the output now here, which is a tabular format of this data. And as you can see, name and department created very clearly. So this is how you set up. And this was the first simple program we executed from here.